Item number
SCP-709.
Index
Eye of the Forest.
Object class
safe.
Special containment procedures.
SCP-709 is currently set up in TAF-2,
Sector 28.
Any staff member is permitted to access the sphere provided they schedule the time in advance, so as to avoid conflict. Class D personnel wishing to use the sphere require permission from their direct supervisor.
Description.
SCP-709 is a spherical
treehouse
assembled from a kit provided by the Company of Vancouver Island. It has been furnished as a small apartment suitable for overnighting. When a person looks out the window for a period of more than 3 to 5 minutes, they will begin to see what appear to be alternative versions of the forest and its inhabitants, such as a
four-winged bird
or a range of bipedal cougars walking down a trail. These visions are not consistent between viewing sessions or between observers during a single session. They can be recorded with conventional video or film equipment, but the equipment will not record the same sights as living observers. Neither will different cameras record the same images, even during simultaneous recording sessions.
Addendum.
SCP-709 first came to Foundation attention when its owner began to complain to his psychiatrist of hallucinations connected to the treehouse. One of our contacts, the psychiatrist, informed us of this anomalous case. After a covert visit to the treehouse on Agent Talmor reported that the sphere was, in fact, an SCP candidate. On her recommendation, the psychiatrist encouraged her patient to replace the sphere. Posing as a local rubbish removal company, a team of agents collected the original sphere and installed it in TAF-2. The original owner no longer complains of hallucinations and ascribes his visions to simple imagination.
Addendum 2.
Personnel who have made use of SCP-709 are encouraged to record their observation in Observation Log 709.
Observation Log 709. Record of observations made from SCP-709.
Please include your name, the date and initial time of observation, and the length of time spent observing.
Name.
Agent Talmor.
Date.
04-01-2009.
Time.
23:15 approximately.
Duration.
20 minutes approximately.
Observed.
A family of raccoons playing in the snow wearing mittens and boots. They made and threw snowballs, built a snow raccoon, and otherwise engaged in normal winter play.
Name.
Agent Thompson.
Date.
06-01-2009.
Time.
19:30.
Duration.
23 minutes.
Observed.
Several species of wildlife, including bears, deer, wolves, birds, sheep, raccoons, and squirrels,
all of which were bipedal,
engaged in warfare, using current-day automatic weapons and several futuristic laser cannons.
Name.
Doctor.
Date.
0108.
Time.
1200.
Duration.
30 minutes.
Observed.
Large, tree-like being, which moved a total of 4 feet during observation. Appeared to wave
branches
several times and
data expunged.
A large viper-like lizard with gliding wings that appear to be part of the ribcage. A small family of grizzly bears which appear to have tongues similar to those of the chameleon, as well as a set of limbs midway down the ribcage.
Data expunged.
Aware of observation. Level of awareness appears to be minimal, and the subject's physical dimensions limit any possibility of interaction.
Name.
Agent Carrion Trooper. 10-07-2009.
Time.
09:10 approximately.
Duration.
50 minutes approximately.
Observed.
Velociraptors hunting a Parasaurolophus. They used obsidian knives to butcher the meat and carried bag-like containers where they put the rest of the meat. They left the scene after butchering the Parasaurolophus. Shortly after they left, small unidentified dinosaurs scurried to the carcass and ate bits of it.
Name.
Agent Hunter and a video camera.
Date.
05-17-2009.
Time.
17:10 approximately.
Duration.
Circa 45 minutes.
Observed.
Agent. At first, a child was seen flying about on a rocking horse, chased by what appeared to be a
small friendly flock of bird.
The birds did not match any native species. After they had flown, several trees were seen to fall, despite not hearing a sound that could explain their fall. Finally, a herd of
miniature elephants
the size of ponies walked past.
Camera.
The camera did not record anything. To be more precise, what it recorded appears to have been a single still image.
It includes at least two birds in mid-flight,
accompanied with the normal sounds of a forest.
Name:
Dr. Light.
Date:
08-10-2009.
Time:
8:30.
Duration:
60 minutes approximately.
Observed:
a single organism of variable size and shape, which emerged from a nearby body of water and proceeded over the following hour to recreate the stages of human evolution. It began as an early amphibian and slowly began to grow legs, arms, fur, teeth, becoming bipedal and using sticks as tools. Once the organism reached the current stage of human development, it continued developing for approximately 5 minutes,
gaining longer fingers and toes and larger eyes,
while diminishing in stature, until it was abruptly consumed by what appeared to be
a very fast, very large SCP-682.
Dr. Light notes that, while slightly disturbing, the process was
scientifically fascinating, and I wish I could have recorded it. Name:
Dr. Garcia.
Date:
11-11-2010. 14:45.
Duration:
25 minutes approximately.
Observed:
environment appears to be flooded to a depth greatly exceeding the altitude of the observation position, with a fluid
inferred to consist of liquid methane
based on neither the surface nor the bottom of the
sea
could be observed, and lighting conditions were very poor. A group of mantra ray-like bioluminescent organisms, each exceeding 40 meters in body length, swam past the observation point at one point.
Name:
Agent Poe.
Date:
03-20-2012.
Time:
17:40.
Duration:
15 minutes approximately.
Observed:
a huge and oddly distorted human face that emerged from just above the viewpoint. It stared directly at the agent for several minutes before
data expunged.
A number of human-like creatures were seen to form out of the remains, all of which seemed to be aware of their observer.
Name:
Dr. Chesnokov.
Date:
05-15-2012.
Time:
12:12.
Duration:
38 minutes approximately.
Observed:
a single male Pan troglodytes,
common chimpanzee,
appeared from the southwest into the view of the observation point, carrying the following: brand smoothie cup in the left hand with a violet liquid visible through transparent straw. Nondescript smartphone in its mouth. Novel entitled under its right arm. Chimpanzee made its way to a tree and proceeded to climb upward until it reached a branch eye level with observer and approximately 30 meters away before sitting. For the rest of the event, the chimpanzee stared intently at the pages within the book, occasionally sipping from its smoothie and checking its smartphone. This continued for 37 minutes until it suddenly stood and climbed back down, leaving from where it entered.
Name:
Researcher Charon.
Date:
06-05-2012.
Time:
11:32.
Duration:
23 minutes approximately.
Observed:
a group of 5 Surikata
meerkat
riding an assortment of 4-wheeled vehicles similar to
cord runners.
All were wearing leather vests, on the backs of which were embroidered a large sun in the middle with a halo on top, the words
Sun Angels
surrounding. Coordinating via unintelligible chirrups and barks, they seemed to be searching for something. After about 10 minutes, they formed a large circle, dismounted their vehicles, and began moving inward. When the circle was about 25 meters in diameter, something sprang from the underbrush at about the center and tried to escape. After turning around and seeing that it was surrounded, it tried to make a last stand. The central figure looked like a wolf hominid. The 5 clan members closed in and eviscerated the wolf creature using their long claws, claiming victory when one of the clan held the wolf's head aloft. A visibly shaken researcher Charon noted,
"I'm never going to be able to watch The Lion King after that."
Name:
Dr. Zara.
Date:
04-10-2012.
Time:
11:17.
Duration:
45 minutes approximately.
Observed:
plant life unchanged. Fauna not visible except for a single enormous horse slowly trekking to the west. Atmospheric dimming suggests horse to be at least 20 kilometers away and more than 5 kilometers in height.
Name:
Researcher Ford.
Date:
12-10-2012.
Time:
13:13.
Duration:
10 minutes approximately.
Observed:
researcher Ford looked thoroughly confused upon exiting the treehouse. He then explained that he had seen four men in lumberjack attire gathered around a log. None of the men had any apparent facial features. One carried a trumpet that appeared to be made of brass and was holding it next to where a mouth would be. Another was dribbling a basketball between both his hands. The third carried a birdcage containing a grey bird similar to a pigeon. The last had a jar of peanut butter and a plastic knife that it was using to butter the log. Researcher Ford was oddly concerned with the fact that the peanut butter jar didn't seem to run out, even after 10 minutes of spreading it on the log. This was noted as within normal parameters and did not warrant any psychological testing.
Name:
Dr. Gums.
Date:
5/27/2013.
Time:
14:35.
Duration:
42 minutes approximately.
Observed:
a swarm of insects resembling Vespa mandarinia, Asian giant hornet, were observed to be feeding on the burnt corpse of an unidentified mammal. After about 10 minutes, a live version of the mammal, seemingly on fire and waterlogged by what appeared to be a bipedal Crocodilus porosus, saltwater crocodile, appeared in view. The bipedal crocodile proceeded to tear off a low-hanging branch of a nearby tree and carve it into a crude approximation of a flute. About 20 minutes in, it played the makeshift flute, causing the hornets to spasm uncontrollably for a period of about 5 seconds and cease motion. The mammal proceeded to systematically crush and consume the hornets for the duration of the observation.
Name:
Dr. Miller.
Date:
13/05/2014.
Time:
10:24.
Duration:
17 minutes.
Observed:
a line of approximately 200 aardvarks, or Incteropus afer, marched past the observation post, two by two. The aardvarks were colored with various bright patterns in a tie-dye fashion.
Name:
Dr. King.
Date:
1/17/2015.
Time:
12:15.
Duration:
exactly 5 minutes.
Observed:
Dr. King came out exactly 5 minutes after having entered, swearing profusely. Eventually, he calmed down enough to explain what he saw. As soon as the vision began, the forest immediately filled with apple seeds up to just below the treehouse. It was at this point that he decided he was done testing it.
Name:
Agent Masterson.
Date:
5/11/2016.
Time:
16:25.
Duration:
8 minutes.
Observed:
two entities appearing as human females, approximately 20 years old, roughly 4 inches, 10 centimeters tall, and possessing iridescent, translucent wings on their backs, flew up to the observation window. They appeared to engage in conversation regarding Agent Masterson, with frequent pointing to him and attempts to look through the window. Then they flew off.
Name:
Dr. Smith.
Date:
6/23/2017.
Time:
09:15.
Duration:
69 minutes.
Observed:
12 grey kangaroos,
Macropus giganteus,
entered view, followed by 6 giant pangolins,
Smutsia gigantea,
which were carrying rolled-up mats. One kangaroo commenced striking the pangolins with a staff, and the pangolins quickly unrolled the mats onto the ground. Two kangaroos went to the head of the area covered, while the others observed. The kangaroos then bowed to each other, and the kangaroos at the front began demonstrating various fighting maneuvers. And then the other kangaroos commenced imitating them. The pangolins remained motionless alongside the mats. After 15 minutes, the first two kangaroos began another series of fighting actions, and again the other 10 imitated them repeatedly for 15 minutes. Then all the kangaroos bowed to each other again and left the mats. One kangaroo again started striking the pangolins with its staff, which then quickly rolled the mats back up, and all 18 entities left the area.